Flap for the Hell Rangers. Today, I'll be beginning a new series of tutorials based around teaching the pilots the basic fundamentals for the various aircraft in DCS World. This series will go through multiple aircraft, however, we'll begin with the F-15C. The F-15C is one of the simple flight model aircraft provided with the Flight and Class 3 package of aircraft. In today's course, first go over the HUD, learning its symbology, and then move into the forward instrument panel of the cockpit. So jumping into the cockpit here, the first thing we're going to do is press enter on our numpad to get the camera into the default view. You can scroll the camera in and out by hitting the slash and asterisk on the numpad, and the various num keys will also change camera settings if you don't have something like track IR or using VR. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do is press right shift and Lima on our keyboard. You will also notice that I'll be using the phonetic alphabet to keep from any confusion between things C, D, E, and T and things of that nature. If you don't know your phonetic alphabet, essentially you'll hear me use a word instead of a letter of reference on the keyboard. The first letter in the word that I use is the keyboard command you need to be associating with. So, with the HUD powered on, we're going to go ahead and start with there. Looking at the top of our HUD, we have the heading ribbon, followed by the vertical carrot underneath it is the heading indicator for the aircraft. The far left of the heading tape, you will see a small vertical line. This indicates the current bearing to the heading for the selected waypoint. This won't necessarily put you on the waypoint path, but it will put you on the same bearing as it. Underneath the heading carrot, you have a plus sign. This is the stationary gun cross. This is used as a indicate the true fire line for the M61 Vulcan located on the right side of the aircraft. Underneath the gun cross, you have two symbols directly on top of each other. One of them is representative of the circle. This is a velocity vector indicator or flight path marker. This gives you the true flight path of the aircraft. Wherever the circle point essentially is where the aircraft is going to wind up. Again, this is known as the VVI or flight path marker. The W, as you see that the VVI is sitting on, is known as the aircraft datum. This gives you the true pitch angle of the aircraft. Essentially what it is a representation of the very tip of the nose of the aircraft. The solid horizontal lines on either side of the VVI are the horizon line indicators. When the velocity vector is in its current position, you are in level flight. The vertical line on the left-hand side of the horizon line is the flight path indicator or bank steering index. This gives you the steering and navigational instructions to the selected waypoint. We'll go over that further when we get into the navigational tutorials. The hashed and solid lines at the top and bottom of the HUD is your pitch scale. These are the lines broken up in 5-degree increments. Wherever the VVI's position is in relation to those, to that pitch scale, will indicate your ascent or descent rate. Or excuse me, not the rate, but the angle. On the left-hand side, you have your indicated airspeed in knots per hour according to true airspeed. The airspeed is indicated by the horizontal carrot, currently approximately 12 knots. To the right of the IAS is your AOA scale, or angle of attack. Again, current angle of attack represented by the horizontal carrot. At the bottom left, you have your accelerometer, or G-limit. 1-0 being the current G-load on the aircraft, 9-0 being the maximum rating for the aircraft itself. On the far right-hand side, you have your altimeter according to barometric pressure, currently showing us at approximately 5,300 feet. And at the bottom right, in navigational mode, which the HUD is currently in, you have the indications of currently selected nav point, distance to the nav point, and estimated time of arrival. That pretty much wraps up the HUD for the navigational portion. Moving down to our next or the gamma zero down the bottom left, which is the ground speed, and tango 1-3, which is your true airspeed, in the bottom right. If you don't know the difference between ground speed and true airspeed, essentially ground speed is the rate at which you're traveling on the surface of the Earth, so similar to what you see in the speedometer in your vehicle. And true airspeed is the speed at which you are flying through the air. Now, the difference between the two gets a little bit more intricate than that. If you don't understand them, I highly recommend that you read up on that, as it does make a bit of a difference when you're referring to aviation. Moving down the cockpit here, we'll go down to our MFD, or multifunction display. In DCS World F-15, this is a top-down view of the aircraft and its current stores. Moving to the parts that are important for us, you have fuel, and fuel up at the very top. The two outer fuels indicate or represent the pylons on the wings, and the center fuel is the fuel pylon on the center of the fuselage. You see 940P with high on the far left. That is 940 rounds of ammunition for the M61 Vulcan with a high rate of fire. Currently, the rate of fire is not adjustable. Opposite side, you have a 120 count of chaff. Chaff is used to defend against radar-guided munitions. A 60 count of flare, which flare are used to defend against infrared, or as you may have heard it, heat seekers. Moving to the triangular shape in the center of the MFD, this is a representation of the aircraft itself. So on the forward end of the fuselage, we have two AIM-120 Bravos, or AMRAMs. On the rear of the fuselage, which is the bottom of the screen, again, two more AIM-120 Bravos, again, known as the AMRAM. On the outer wings, we have two AIM-120 Charlies, and on the inner stores, we have two AIM-9 Mikes, Sidewinders. Alright, so if we were to step outside the aircraft for a second to get an idea of what that actually looks like, we'll go ahead and back up a hit here. Alright, so you see on the outer wing stores are two AIM-120Cs. You have on the inner stores the two AIM-9s. And if we were to walk around the side here, we have four, two on each side. You have the two on the forward that we saw, AIM-120 Bravos, and the two on the rear of the fuselage. And the two wing tanks on the wing pylons, and the one for the center fuselage. Alright, go ahead and see what's going on over there. Alright. Let's go ahead and jump back in the cockpit. Alright. So, looking at our gauges now. First thing we're going to do is go ahead and bring up the cockpit lights. It's getting a little dark, so we're going to press LIMA on our keypad. Beginning with the top gauge, we have our indicated airspeed in the mechanical gauge. Beginning with 50 knot increments up to 200 knots. At 200 knots, it moves into 100 knot increments. The inner gauge with the larger needle represents your speed in Mach. Alright, so next we have our angle of attack, so AOH, just like we saw on the HUD here, with the 1-0 and the 9-0. And then we have our accelerometer, the 1-0 on the AOA meter, so the right scale, the inner right scale. The bottom is the accelerometer, which is showing us our G-limit, which that's what you will see at the bottom left of the HUD with the 1-0 and 9-0. So again, you see 1-0 here, and 1-0 here. That means we are forcing one time the G-limit, having one time the force of gravity. Moving into the center gauges, we have our ADI, or Attitude Director Indicator. The W, again, symbology, which is the aircraft datum, shows the current pitch angle of the aircraft. The scale will move up and down based on the pitch of the aircraft, and then left and right based on the bank angle. The solid white line in the center of the EEI is our horizon line. The vertical line on the left-hand side of the ADI is your current flight path marker or waypoint indicator. The solid horizontal line down the bottom is used for establishing the glide slope. We'll go into that more when we have our HSI, or horizontal situation indicator. This is a top-down view of the aircraft and its current flight path information. We will go into further detail on that when we get into navigation. Top of right on the HSI is the current course heading of the currently selected waypoint. Moving up to the top right, we have our TEWS, our Tactical Electronic Warfare System, also known as the RWR, or Radar Warning Receiver. The purpose of this instrument is to alert the pilot of any radar contacts that the aircraft is currently picking up. The symbology of the contact will change based on what the radar signature is doing. So, for example, if the target is locking you, or if it just passed a signal. And again, we'll go into that further when we start getting into the combat aspect of aircraft. Moving down, we have our altimeter, again, showing barometric pressure. Notice there will be a slight difference between what you see here and what you see on the HUD. Next, we have our vertical velocity indicator, showing your ascent or descent rate in thousands of feet per minute. Then we have a clock. Moving over, we have two rows of identical gauges. These are the left and right engine readouts. Top being the RPM and percentage used. Then we have our exhaust temperature, fuel flow indicator in pounds per hour, and our exhaust nozzle position indicators. This represents the open or closed position of the exhaust nozzles at the rear of the aircraft. And finally, at the far right, we have our fuel quantity gauge showing total fuel on board in pounds. We're going to move over to the far left of the cockpit real quick for two more little items. You'll see nose left and right. When these lights are illuminated, that means the landing gear is down. When the lights are out, the landing gear is retracted. Obviously, you want to take a peek at that before you come in for your final approach. To the left of the landing gear knob there, you'll see a light that says radio call. Above that radio call are two light indicators. One will say flaps in green. This means that the flaps are in their landing position. When the flap light is illuminated in yellow, means that the flaps are currently in motion, and when the lights are dark, the flaps are retracted. I hope that you guys enjoyed this first tutorial, and I hope it helped you break down some of the